Hi my dear student, today we will discuss chapter 4, inverse trigonometric functions. Exercise 4.2, question number 5. Find the value of 2 times cos inverse of half plus sine inverse of. In this case, you must know the principal value of sine inverse x and cos inverse x. Okay, you must know the principal value of sine inverse x and cos inverse x. See here. Principal value of sine inverse x is between minus 90 comma plus 90, and principal value of cos inverse x is 0 to 180. So you must know the principal range of the principal value of sine inverse x, which is therefore principal value of sine inverse x between minus 90 and plus 90, principal value of cos inverse x is 0 to pi. In this case, we have 2 cos inverse half plus sine inverse half. 2 cos inverse half. 1 by 2 will come in cosine 60 degree. Pi by 3. Sine inverse half. 1 by 2 will come in sine as 30 degree. Pi by 6. When you take LCM 6. Multiply by 2. So 2 2's are 4 pi plus pi. It will be 5 pi by 6. That's all. Is it clear? So 2 times cos inverse of pi by 3, which lies between 0 to pi. Sin inverse of pi by 6, which lies between minus 90 to plus 90. I took LCM, simplify. Finally, we are getting 5 pi by 6, which is the required solution. Is it clear? Now, second option from the same problem. Cos inverse of plus sin inverse minus 1. Cos inverse of 1 by 2 will come at 60 degree, pi by 3. Sin inverse minus 1. So, minus 1, it will be minus pi by 2. What is sin minus 90? Minus sin 90. Sin 90 gives 1, which is minus pi by 2, which lies in the principal value. So, when you take LCM 6, 3 2's are. 2 will come here and 3 will come here, plus into minus, minus 3. So it will be minus pi by 6. That's all. So cos inverse of, whose principal value is pi by 3. Sin inverse minus 1. Sin inverse 1 gives 90 degree. Sin inverse minus 1 gives minus 90 degree. Okay. When you take LCM, 3 2's are 6. 2 into pi, 2 pi. Plus into minus, minus 3 into pi, 3 pi. 2 pi minus 3 pi minus pi by 6. That's all. Question number 3. We have cos inverse within bracket cos pi by 7 cos pi by 17 minus sin pi by 7 sin pi by 17. Here I will use the formula cos a plus b. What is cos a plus b? Cos a plus b equal to cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Got it? Cos a plus b equal to cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So I can write cos inverse, which is nothing but cos a plus b. Cos a plus b. So cos inverse. When you take LCM, 17 into 7. 17 comes here pi plus 7 comes here 7 pi. Cos inverse, cos, when you add 24 pi divided by 7, 7, 7, 49, 4, 7 plus 4, 1. So, cos inverse of cos 24 pi by 119. Since, cos inverse cos theta equal to theta if theta lies between 0 to pi. Cos inverse of cos theta equal to theta if theta lies between 0 to pi. The value of 24 into pi divided by 119 lies between this one. So I can write cos inverse of cos 24 pi by 119 as 24 pi by 119. Got it? So in this case, here it will be in the form of cos a cos b minus sin a sin b, which is nothing but cos a plus b. So I will use cos a plus b. When you simplify the bracket, I am getting 24 pi divided by 119, whose value belongs to this interval 0 to pi. So I can write directly 24 pi by 119. Got it?